Does he? Quite right. It's Freddie Laker.
Not the fastest man across the Atlantic, isn't
he? That's right. Freddie Laker and his airlines. He had an airline.
Yes.
And it was... It went bust.
Yes, which is not really fitting the description of winning, is it?
Well, good answer.
I don't know. I'm sorry.
Any ideas over there?
He held up a plane that I was on in Nairobi for about 3 hours. Believe that or not?
Well, hijacked it.
No. Well, we were waiting to get back because his airline had just gone bust, and he and his wife, we had to wait for them for 3 hours to get them home.
I think we should have a point for that story.
Well, yeah, it's a good story. It's true. And then he came on and there was a hushed silence, you know, in the aeroplane as he walked down. It's really very embarrassing.
I think we're heading for 2 points here.
Yeah.
What airline were you flying with?
I can't remember. But he was coming out on this and we had to wait for him for 3 hours. He had to hold up his plane, I think. His plane that was, plane out.
Pretty fair stuff then, I thought.
It was very exciting, you know, these things that have happened to me.
We're going back to 1 point.
We're always hoping with this concept behind Telly Years that stories like this would start to emerge. Right, he won the Golden Jester Award, which is given by cartoonists to anybody who gives them the maximum opportunity come up with material. And
Isla?
Yes.
Here's yours.
Aha, the Dimblebees. Investigative journalism. Nope.
No.
Well, mouth.
Yes, Sharron.
Is it supposed to do with his hair?
Yes.
He was the head of the year
in 1978, awarded by the National Hairdressers Federation.
Very good.
Alan, talk us through this, please.
Talk you through this?
Yep.
Well, it's definitely no pace, no technique. Can't defend. And I'll tell you this much, Des, I can't believe it's on the field.
Very good.
Very good.
Now, what's the correct answer?
Why is it a new one? You can see that.
Well, it's a small one, isn't it?
It says M.
Is it something to do with farming?
Is it a combine harvester? It's not a combine harvester. It's a seed mate. It's something else, isn't it? What is it?
Combine harvester.
It is a combine harvester. Why are the people laughing?
Can you tell us what it is? What is it?
The combine harvester was the toy of the year. Let's have the scores. Isla and Alan have got 7. Paul and Sharron have got 7. Yeah. 1978 was the year of Saturday Night Fever, white suits, and the first World Disco Dancing Championships. So young, they train on a diet of Pacific in brine, which you can buy for just 59p. Okay, I'll throw this amongst all four of you. Tony Manero was the main character in Saturday Night Fever. Who played him?
George Travolta.
Yeah, very good. Alan. Who performed the title music? Sharron gets it. Name any other hits from the film.
Saturday Night
Fever. You're the one that I love. Was that from it?
No, that's Greece.
What was it? Disco Inferno.
Yes.
If I can't have you, Yvonne Elliman sung it.
Yes.
Tavares. What? More than an angel.
More than a woman. Yes.
More than a woman. Yeah, more than an angel.
He's got the album, you know.
And I tell you what, I used to move like that before my knees went as well.
You could have had Boogie Shoes, Staying Alive, Jive Talking. That's very good.
I was going to say those.
What was the sequel called?
Staying Alive.
Yes, Staying Alive.
Well done.
And when you think Alan would be too embarrassed to let that kind of knowledge fly out. Information flying around like pilchards there. True or false? Sharron and Paul, more bizarre stories, but are they true or have we just made them up?
At the World Cowpat Throwing Contest in Beaver City, a new world record of 272 feet is set.
I think that's true. Do you?
Sharron?
Yes, of course you do.
False.
No, I don't mind. No, go on, let's say true.
All right, let's say true. Okay.
Well, you're right, it was true. The record...
Well done.
The world cowpat throwing record in the end was thrown out because it was found to be wind-assisted.
Oh, dear.
Isla and Alan.
Here's yours.
Following the discovery of a buffalo living in someone's garden, an elephant is found living rough in the New Forest.
There could be an extra point here for you two if you answer in the way in which they did.
So I'll say true and you say false.
Correct. Because the bit about the buffalo is true, but the elephant had escaped from Windsor Safari Park.
Yeah.
Well done, 2 points.
Yes.
Hey, when we were digging around in the archives, we found that Eurovision moment. I mean, people go on and on about Norway once getting nil point. Well, in 1978, they got the big zero, and we found the tune. Score time on Telly Years. 8 to Sharron and Paul, but Isla and Alan have got 14! And my thanks to Sharron Davies and Paul Darrow, to Alan Hanson and Isla and Clair. We're going to leave you from this little trip through 1978 with some genuine news about a lady in America who was finally convicted of murdering her husband. It was after a number of unsuccessful attempts, during which she tried
putting a dose of LSD on his toast, placing bullets in the carburetor of his lorry, tossing a live electric wire into his shower, injecting his veins with a hypodermic to induce a heart attack, and serving him with blackberry pie containing the venom sac of a tarantula.
But she didn't try the pilchards! And Yorkshire TV, with their sitcom Life Begins at 40, starring Derek Nimmo and Rosemary Leach, was sold to East Germany.
Not as a comedy, but as part of their adult education program to encourage people to have more babies.
We're going to leave you with a clip from 1978 that I think would have exactly the reverse effect. From Telly Years, good night!
When you play a tune on the flute,